Howdy, bitches. We're starting off with Bent Over Barbell Rows, man. We gonna get it. Want to make sure you're fucking squeezing it, bro.
God forgives and I don't. It's one of my many emotions. That's one of my many flaws. I am flawed. It may not seem that way, but I am. So don't play with me.
Go, bro, go.
I said no, Bo. No! I thought you said go, Bo, go.
Chop this off the tag. So this here is one of the newer Paramount back machines. If you notice the handles here, you can adjust them depending on how wide you want to go.
Fuck a pigeonhole, I'm a night out, it's a different mode. I'ma have to make a paint of six on a pinky toe. Heard you with a shooting guard, just let a nigga know. I would have your court side, not the middle row. All good love in a minute though. I can't stress about no bitch cause I'm a timid soul. Plus I'm cooking up ambition on the kitchen stove. Pot start to bubble, see the suds, that shit good to go.
Hey, you're a handsome young man. You feel that, bro?
Hey, man.
Feels horrible. Whoa, Jonathan. You finally hopped on the sauce.
I'm not supposed to say that.
Gotta throw a party for my day ones. They ain't in the studio, but they'll lay some. Rest in peace, the drama king. He was straight.
Come on. Super shit.
There's some points on
me? Hey, why are you here, bro? Tell me about this machine.
Hey, we're gonna talk about this amazing chest press right here. It was recommended by a good old friend of mine, Jonathan Day, aka Jonathan the Beast, aka Bro John Beast, aka the Beast. Yeah, it's got a stack of 285 pounds, amazing machine, and it's made by an old school company called Flex Fitness. Never heard of it before. We only have it here, Roman Empire Gym. My home, your home, Solomon's home, God's home.
Shows what the pegs are made of.
All right, guys, we're gonna do full stack.
Oh.
Ooh,
I like that a lot.
Yeah. God damn, John.
I wait.
Look at that, bro. See how big those titties are? I can make lunch.
Come on. Oh.
Big old titties.
Come on. Oh.
If I let my nigga 21 tell it you a pussy. Spin a block twice like it ain't nowhere to park. Smack the back side of his head like he bark. OVO for well, we come out when it get dark. Big stepper, he came in the road, but he left in the stretcher. Let my brother drive while I shoot team effort. Asking all these questions, but you must thank you Nadeska. The chopper like the fill on all the artists of molester. I be with my gun like Rose be with lemon pepper. She wanna hear some apple
juice,
she just popped a Tesla. All that working out, that nigga must think he a wrestler. But this ain't UFC, this chopper came with a compressor. This chopper came with a compressor. This chopper came with a this Glock 45 came with a switch. If I was Will Smith, I would've slapped him with a stick. Put your hands in the air, it's a sticker. Spin the same hood where I get my
dick. George, you need to be a little bit taller for the camera angle.
Maybe you're just gonna be a little shorter, buddy.
Oh, my bad.
Let's spit some real shit real fast. Listen, guys, if you wanna train hard, bro, you need to fucking get that mind and muscle connection. You've gotta learn to use your breathing, pressure your body. Push, and don't give yourself an overexertion headache. It hurts really bad. Make sure you breathe, but brace, press, exhale, breathe. Make sure you're doing that each time. You're getting the most activation, as you can see. Let's go.
Are you all right, Jonathan?
No, I'm not all right.
Bro, the trend's getting to him.
That's called
Team Nope Out.
Yo, something's happening, bro. Bro. I don't know what's going on.
Charles, are you good, brother?
Woo. Pushed a little too hard on that last set, man.
As you can see, this handle, there's two different attachments that allow you to pull the bar even further down and really get your hands to tuck into the shoulders there. This is really good because, like you can see, what he's doing is you can twist your hands and really get a good squeeze on the back.
All right, guys, we're on T-bar rows now. Let's see how it's done.
T-bar rows for the hose. Right, wait.
Come on, bro.
Yeah. Let's go, Solomon. Yeah. Hey, do some posing for us, bro. What you got? What you got?
Hey, dude, you're right on
time,
man. Hey, Jonathan.
George, can't you see I'm flexing, bro?
That's a wrap on the workout, guys, but I want to talk about a concept here. So basically what I did today is I hadn't picked up the camera and filmed myself for quite a while, and something I want to point out to you is this perspective. So when I walked into the gym, I felt a little nervous about pulling the camera out and just starting to talk into it, but the reality is if I pull the camera out and I start filming as if this is my full-time job and this is something I've been doing for years, I'm very relaxed and very comfortable, and it's very normal to me. There's other guys in the gym who also want to film and pull out their cameras, but the thing is they're looking around to see if anyone else is doing it. And so when they see me filming, it makes them feel better. They're like, oh, that guy's filming. Well, this camera over there. It makes me feel better about pulling out my camera. So rather than, you know, you want to pull out your camera and you want to film, but you're looking around and you don't see anybody doing it, be the first person to do it. And you're going to realize that people are watching. And whenever they see that you pull your camera out and you're filming and you're having fun, they're gonna wanna do the same thing. It's more of an encouraging sort of perspective to have versus thinking that here I am with my, you know, no subscribers or very small channel and I'm out here filming in the gym, I'm that guy. No, your identity has to be coherent. It has to be parallel with what you're doing. And if you don't identify as somebody who picks up the camera and is vlogging and just having fun with it, then you're not gonna do it in the long term. You're gonna feel very awkward and it's not gonna feel like you. And the thing is, if you don't identify with something, you're never gonna stick to it. So the most important thing for us to do is be able to take out that camera and be like, yo, this is what I do. And I'm having fun with it, man. I really don't care what people think. I wanna document my personal stuff and I wanna share it. This is something I do for fun. And when you approach it with that mindset, it's gonna be a lot easier for you to take that camera out and start filming your stuff, having fun with it. And you'll notice that people actually gravitate. So you're gonna repel people who aren't really with it, but you're going to attract people who love it. And they wanna be in your video, they wanna be a part of it, they wanna be near you. You're gonna notice there's a big change, man, and it's good. You wanna align with those kind of people. So I encourage you, man, if you're on the fence about it or you just feel weird or you don't feel like you're that type of person, embody it. Even imagine yourself pulling out the camera and filming and talking and just having fun with it before you actually go out there and do it. And remember that there's other people watching and they're looking for inspiration. They're looking for a reason to do the things that they really want to do. And when you pull out your camera, that's your reason, is to inspire the other people in here who want to film to do it. So take that and do something productive with it.